ultimately, the whole purpose of number four is to move people into number five, right? And what is number five? Number five is the most common asset that most people would know of, which is basically the capital asset. Asset that helps you generate a positive cash flow, right? Now, obviously, this could be an entire three-day event on its own talking about positive cash flow assets. But ultimately, why are we building up the social asset, the digital asset, the proprietary asset, and systems asset? Is so that we can use the money and the profit that we are making and push it and reinvest it back into business, into things that produce positive cash flow. Now, in the context of marketing and business and in this industry, what does it mean? It means reinvesting that cash flow into the business. Okay, so how can you utilize this in the context of social media? So for example, my team, when it comes to social media, they are given a budget every single month to spend on reinvesting it in building an audience and a following. Okay, so for example, inside Instagram, my Instagram manager would take care of, for example, these shout out campaigns. So for example, this example here is from Millionaire Mentor, which is someone who is someone that we advertise with our shout outs. And we do it with many different people. So if you notice, like on his page, you notice about every 3 to 5 days, they will do a shout out and make a post and link it back to us. And we work with about 50 plus different influencers to do these shout outs for us. And what we're really doing is my team is taking an allocated budget and paying these different influencers to do these shout outs that in turns get us a bigger following. So what is it really doing? We are utilizing that to fuel number one again, right? It goes back into number one, which is the social asset. It goes full circle. We're taking the thing that's generating us positive cash flow. We're now empowering our team, giving them a specific budget, free hand to spend this money however they want, with just one report at the end of each month on how they're utilizing that budget to fuel number one again. Okay, this could be shout out campaigns, this could be giveaways, this could be all these different things. Slightly bigger picture. So this was a studio that I built recently, last year. So we paid about 800 grand buying up this unit, and we transformed it into like a full-fledged CMN style type of thing. And the purpose of that is, again, to use that to fuel number one. So what do I do? What did I use this studio for? If you watch like my YouTube videos, you notice like a lot of my videos are shot in this studio. We've got about 6 different sets in this studio over here. Why do I do that? It is because I'm thinking about this framework. I'm thinking about how can I take number five and use it to fuel number one again, which in turn fuels number two, number three, number four, number five, right? Circle. So on top of that, to take it another step further, I've built a funnel around it. I have a funnel that says, how would you like to join me in my private studio and work with my team to build up these assets for you, right? One-of-a-kind experience, and that's what I do. So I'm thinking about this big picture framework every single time I am doing everything that I do, okay? So what is the number one thing that is going to stop people from implementing? Because the thing that you can't outsource is step number one, right? Step number one still requires you to do that initial work of shooting the videos that's keyword rich and putting yourself out there, especially if you're starting out. And many times when people look at what I do, it is easy to assume that Ping Jun seems to be this guy that loves being a limelight and is extroverted. But the truth is, if you know my story, so this was me. Somehow I was in the trunk of my dad's car. My dad, he was a farmer for about 17 years of his life. He was an extremely hardworking man. And the thing about my story is that my dad, this is how I was brought up. my dad would bring me and to my brother and I to spend time on the farm. And we were pretty much on the weekends, I would be on this farm, hanging out here where it's hot and there's nothing to do for a really long time. So doing what I'm doing today is not something that I'm supposed to be doing, okay? And when I create, if you know my journey, I never wanted to be doing social media or to be in the limelight. If you know my story, I started off from this background, right? I was this gamer who played World of Warcraft for over 1,000 hours in my college days. And my first ever product was literally this ebook over here on World of Warcraft. And it was a product that I released in 2007. So this is like 13 years ago. And when I created this ugly looking sales page 13 years ago, I truly thought that nobody would buy from a person named Ping Jun, right? True story. I thought, you know what? If people have trouble pronouncing my name, chances are they're not going to buy it. So I created this pen name, some of you might have heard, called Tony Sanders. I took, you know, Tony Robbins and Colonel Sanders, merged these two names together. That's how I came up with that name. So a lot of my products that I created back in the day was all marketed under Tony Sanders because I didn't want to be in the limelight. And the truth is, life was really good marketing in all these different markets, especially in gaming, until this one thing happened. Okay, so I went to many different weird markets in Farmville, absolutely crushing it. And then I built this list of over 500,000 people. My list, overnight, I got this email from AWeber, which is the company that I was working with, and overnight, they shut my account down. And the reason for that was I realized, to my horror, I made a mistake sending out an email to my list of gamers, this dating offer, because they were both marketed under Tony Sanders. So the night before, when I was sending out this email for one of my niche products, which is a dating product, I accidentally sent it to my gaming list as well. So there's like 500,000 nerds receiving an offer on dating, which you would think it would convert well, right? But spam complaints was really high. They shut my account down overnight. And just like that, I lost my entire list. And I was working with this company called AWeber. Anyone here using AWeber? Okay, you guys are screwed, okay? AWeber refused to give me a backup of my list, even though, you know, it would cost them nothing, but somehow they refused to give me a backup. I didn't back up my list for some reason. So I lost my entire business just like that. And I was forced to make a decision to start all over again. And I thought, what if I could teach people what I did in the gaming market and teach people how they can monetize what they know as well? And for the first time, looking back in retrospect, this is what forced me to get out of my comfort zone and start creating and putting myself out there. So 2012 was the year this happened. This is when I started putting myself out there. And people just look at the result. Okay, they look at the big stages. They look at the table rushes. They look at all these different, you know, they look at the sizzle reel. Okay, but what people don't see is the real reel. I believe some of you might have seen this video. How many of you here have seen this video, right? How many of you have not seen this video? Oh, okay. So this video over here was a video of my first ever speaking event that I attended. And one of the things that I didn't know about this speaking event until many years later was that it was actually recorded. And many years later, the organizer asked me, he said, "Hey, Ping Jun, do you know that your presentation at the event was recorded?" And I didn't know. And he said, "Would you like to see it?" And I said, "No," because I knew it would be cringy and horrible at the same time. But what people don't see, what the rest of the world don't see, is that I was absolutely horrible, okay? You guys want to see it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so here... Guys, by the way, this video is not on YouTube, and I'm not mentally prepared for it still, to be on YouTube. Is it cool that, you know, you guys don't record this? Yeah? Okay, cool. Okay, so here's what happened, okay?
Okay, so what's going to happen tonight, you're going to have to write clearly and larger. Because when you do that, everything looks really, first of all, confusing and unimportant. Yep. So at dinner tonight, I want you to practice, you use this flip chart or something, practice writing like I write or Blair writes.
Okay.
That's not going to work. People will be going, what the fuck did he, why can't I see it? And now it looks unimportant. And you're now spending more time thinking about the fact that I can't read it than what you're talking about. Guys, yes or yes?
So you can see my handwriting was absolutely horrible, and it hasn't really, you know, improved over time. But here's what happened next, okay? So at this training, one of the things that I was learning was how to make a pitch and an offer on stage, right? So this was totally new to it, no idea how it works, here's what happened.
You see, the hotel which I booked only allows up to 40 people. And right now,
speed it up.
I think there's only 21 spots left. So,
you cannot say, I think there's only 21. Is there or isn't there? Just say there's 21 spots available.
I think there's only 21
spots. No, you cannot say, I think, because you sound like you don't know what you're talking about. Okay. You can't say, I think. Don't you know?
There's only 21 spots left.
And now there's only 21 spots left.
And now there's only 21 spots left. So here's what I'm going to do. For the next 21 people... For the first 21 people who go to the back and register...
Stop! You're putting me to sleep, man! Wake up! Jump up and down 5 times. Go! Jump, jump, jump! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now.
And that's how I started off. Okay. So this thing right here is what the rest of the world does not see. I can tell you that many times when I go on stage, without a script, without a music stand, which I've not used in like 8 years, it looks like Ping Jun has it easy. It looks like Ping Jun has this talent or this gift in speaking and teaching, and people will only see the end result. People will not see the challenges, the struggles, the journey. And I can tell you that at this event over here, very honestly, I was the bottom 5% of this room. I can tell you the other 95% of people in this room, there's 100 people there, they were more charming, more confident, they knew the words, they had more experience, and I was easily the bottom 5 in this room, okay? In fact, I don't think there was any other person that was asked, that was yelled at and asked to do jumping jacks like that. I was probably the only person, okay? But fast forward today, I can tell you that at the same time, in terms of speaking, now that I've spoken more than 20 countries around the world, I don't think there's anyone else in that room that has done what I've done in the world of speaking. And I'm not saying that to compare, like really I'm not, but I'm saying that to show you that talent can only bring you that far in life. But the rest is all heart. And your heart and your burning desire and how hungry you are, that's on you. And I would choose good habits over talent any day, because good habits is in your control. The reason why most people never begin, whether it's content creation or shooting that YouTube video or speaking in front of stages, is because they're not willing to be bad at something in order to be good at it. Most of the time when people shoot that first video and they're horrible at it, they blame it on not having the talent, not having the gift. Same thing with this. Most of the time when people do something that's new to them and they're horrible at it, they blame it on not having the gift and therefore they never achieve mastery. The journey to mastery is really just in practice. When I started here, I started the same way how anyone that is new to the game would start off. I didn't know what to say. I had to print out and write up my entire script on a piece of paper because I didn't have the confidence to not have a script. I started off the same way how most people would start off, trying to memorize each and every single word. I started off practicing in front of the mirror, doing it over and over again, which is basically what the rest of the world doesn't see. Okay, that's how I started off. So if you are serious about this journey, the hardest thing that the barrier that you would have to go through is really just that internal conversation here that you're dealing with every single day. Okay, so let's talk about the implementation. How would this work? Okay, so I want to share with you, like, now that you understand these are the five-step process, how do you actually apply this in your business even after you leave this event? I believe, like, you guys have been here for like 2 hours. Do you guys need a break?
No.
How many of you here need a break?
Do you need a break?
I don't know if I need a break. Okay, so you know what? Let's take 5 minutes. Did you guys have a break this morning?
No.
There's no breaks this morning?
No.
Is Steve here? Does Steve want a break? Okay, let's take like a 5 minute break. When you guys come back, we're gonna resume with this thing. So 5 minutes. Okay, we'll resume.